नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माई सेल्फ जीवीएन डॉक्टर रितु शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ गायनियोप्स, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडे सेशन इज लैक्टेशन। लैक्टेशन फॉर द फर्स्ट टू डेज फॉलोइंग डिलीवरी, नो फर्दर anatomic changes in the breast occur. The secretion from the breast called colostrum, which start during pregnancy, become more abundant during the period. Composition of the colostrum: it is deep yellow serous fluid, alkaline in reaction. It has got a higher specific gravity, a high protein, vitamin A, sodium and chloride content, but has got lower carbohydrate, fat and potassium than the breast milk. Colostrum and milk contain immunologic components such as immunoglobulins, IgA. Complements macrophages, lymphocytes, lactoferrin, and other enzymes like lactoferrin oxidase, and microscopically, it contains fat globules, colostrum, corpuscles, and acinar's epithelial cells. The colostrum corpuscles are large polynuclear leukocytes, oval or round in shape, containing numerous fat globules. Composition of colostrum and breast milk: protein, fat, carbohydrate, and water. Advantage: the antibodies IgA, IgG, and IgM, and humoral factors lactoferrin provides immunological defense to the newborn. It has laxative action on the baby because of large fat globules. Physiology of lactation. Although lactation starts from following delivery, the preparation for effective lactation starts during pregnancy. The physiological basis of lactation is divided into four phases. First is preparation of breast. This is called mammogenesis, and synthesis and secretion from the breast alveoli. This is called lactogenesis. Ejection of milk. This is called galactokinesis. And last is maintain of lactation. This is called galactopoiesis. Mammogenesis, lactogenesis, galactokinesis, and galactopoiesis. These are four stages. Yeah, four phases of the physiological basis of lactation. Now, first is mammogenesis. Pregnancy is associated with remarkable growth of both ductal and lobulo-alveolar system. An inactive nerve supply is not essential for the growth of mammary glands during pregnancy. Now, lactogenesis: the alveolar cells are the principal sites for production of milk. Some secretory activity is evident. Colostrum during pregnancy and accelerated pollen delivery. Milk secretion actually start on third and fourth postpartum day. Around this time, the breasts become engorged, tense, and tender, and feel warm. In spite of a high prolactin level during pregnancy, milk secretion is kept in abeyance. Probably steroids, estrogen, and progesterone circulating during pregnancy make the breast tissue under responsive to prolactin. When the estrogen and progesterone are withdrawn following delivery, prolactin being its milk secretory activity in previously fully developed mammary glands. Prolactin, insulin, growth hormone, and glucocorticoids are the important hormone in this stage. The secretory activity is also enhanced directly or indirectly by growth hormone, thyroid, and insulin. For milk secretion is occur, nursing effort is not essential. Now third is galactokinase. Oxytocin is the major galactokinetic hormone. Discharge of milk from the mammary gland depend on the suction exerted by the baby during suckling, but also on the contractile mechanism which expels the milk from the alveoli into the duct. During suckling, considered conditions, reflex is set up. The ascending tickle impulses from the nipple and areola pass via thoracic sensory. 5, 4, 5, and 6. Afferent neural arc is to the paraventricular and supraoptic nuclei of the hypothalamus to synthesize and transport oxytocin to the posterior pituitary. Oxytocin efferent via blood is liberated from the posterior pituitary, produce contraction of the myoepithelial cells of the alveoli and the ductus containing the milk. This is milk ejection or milk letdown reflex, whereby the milk is forced down into the ampulla of the lactiferous duct. And last is galactopoiesis. Prolactin appears to be the single most important galactopoiesis hormone. The maintenance of the effective and continuous lactation, frequency of suckling is essential. Distension of the alveoli by retained milk is due to failure of suckling. This cause decreases in the milk secretion by the alveolar epithelium. Ductal and alveolar distension due to failure of milk transfer is caused in lactation failure. Milk pressure reduces the rate of production and hence periodic breastfeeding is necessary. Milk production. A healthy mother will produce about 500 to 800 ml of milk a day to feed her baby. This requires about 700 kilocalories per day for the mother, which must be made up from diet or from her body store. For this purpose, a store of about 5 kg of fat during pregnancy is essential to make up any nutritional deficit during lactation. Stimulation of lactation. Mother is motivated as regard to the benefits of breastfeeding since the early pregnancy. No prelactal feeds, honey or water, are given to the infant. Following delivery, important steps are: first is to put the baby to the breast at 2 to 3 hours interval from the first day. Second is plenty of fluid to drink, and third is to avoid breast engorgement early, 0.5 to 1 hours, and exclusive breastfeeding is correct position is increased. In advocate, milk production like milk failure may be due to infrequent suckling or due to engorgeous suppression of prolactin. Ergot preparation, peridoxine, diuretics, or retained placenta bites. Pain and anxiety and insecurity may be the hidden reason. Unrestricted feeding at short interval, 2 to 3 hours, is helpful. Drugs to improve milk production. Lactogenous. These are allopathic drugs for the promote the milk production. Methods commonly used are to stop breastfeeding, to avoid pumping or milk expression, to wear breast support, ice packs to prevent engorgement, analgesics to relieve pain, and a tight compression bandage is applied for 2 to 3 days. The neural inhibition of prolactin secretion will result in breast involution. Medical method of suppression with estrogen, androgen, or bromopriestine is not advised. The side effects of bromocriptine are hypotension, rebound secretion, seizure, myocardial infarction, and puerperal stroke. Breast milk for premature infant is beneficial by many ways: psychological, nutrition, and immunological. Metabolic disturbances like azotemia, hyperaminoacidemia, and metabolic acidosis are less with breast milk compared to formula. It gives immunological protection to the premature infant. There are methods for collection, manual expression, or electric pumps, and milk preservation. This session is powered by digital version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.